this time, I thought my right eye was failing. It's been an odd trick of Duffy in my glasses pocket. It's one of the less common eye diseases, treacle Duffy. I wonder how they'd have cured me if I hadn't discovered it in time. Massive injections of wine gums.
Chloe, Chloe, you fool. For nothing. That's usually the attraction.
We've never been to a road safety exhibition. They keep having them. They must fulfill some deep-seated need.
Come on, kiddies. There are plenty of other places we've never been which have a higher priority than road safety exhibitions.
Such as what?
The crematorium. I always wanted to go to the Canary Islands one day. Well, turn left when you get outside and shove off. Left? I thought it were right for Canary Islands.
Oh, well, if you want to go far, Egmont Wike.
Doesn't everybody wish your sense of adventure?
I used up most of mine when I had to give that musket doctress a pound.
Oh, with all that black leather. Oh, Mrs. Lucas.
Aye. Funny name for Elba's turnbound Fuhrer. Mr. Lucas.
That were her boss what got Ernie Bignum.
I expect she threw him under for offering a pound.
She was a big lass.
Oh, a retake wheeler.
Bit full on the upper deck.
They were her main assets.
If that top button never goes, there'll be scenes of wild disorder. Whatever happened to Ernie Bignum then?
He tore all his jacket.
Poor thing. God, how awful being run over by Mrs. Lucas.
I've had to try my skill on the driving simulator.
The what?
The driving simulator.
Well, it's got a kid on it. They should be told in the choppers aren't you to start playing with trains.
It's a test of one's reflexes and coordination.
And some of us have more than others, which explains why we don't spit fragments of Eccles cake and dribble, aren't we?
You don't know how to enjoy out. It makes me sick to see you nibbling at a biscuit. You're like some old spinster always making sure and checking to see her knees are closed.
Have you ever heard the expression, suffer little children? Well, get off before it starts.
What's all this about, Nick?
It's a serious instrument. Like the bassoon or veterinary pliers. You turn the wheel, watch the screen, and it tells you where you are on the road.
That's rubbish. We know where we are on the road. We're in Percy Street.
Hasn't he got a wonderful sense of direction?
The question is, can the modern motor vehicle be trusted? You slacken your grasp on the reins for an instant, and it's liable to leap out and savage some other fella's car. Then you have to have it destroyed.
Oh.
I can't say I've ever been all that fond of motor cars, but you don't like to think of anybody being cruel to them.
Hey, they're all right, these cars. How did that one?
Well, that's no recommendation. He used to have scabs on his chin, but they never caught on with the general public.
It was only sore spots. He chapped easy.
Another one dribbling his tea.
No, it wasn't. Dr. Murray said he had an extra fine skin.
You're Eric?
Yeah. When he stripped off, he had a skin like a lily.
No wonder he used to get so intense about rugby league.
The ride's rough there, Eric. If he hadn't died young, nobody would have had a good word to say for him.
Have you never fancied the idea of learning to drive?
Yeah. I know about them driving instructors. They get you down the back lane and the next thing is they've got their hand on your welly.
Is that a road or a river?
I don't know. Stay there. You went right up on the back.
Oh, here we go.
Get there. How long have you been driving then as the crow flies?
It's just pure mechanical envy on your part. That's all you're suffering from?
Well, I thought you showed great originality. Most folk would have been content to stay on road.
It just came to me.
I've never seen such a performance.
It's nice to think that after all these years, my standard of driving has hardly changed. Comforting, isn't it, that there are still a few things left untouched? But if we had a real car, we could get about more.
smell more. The way you drive, you spend half the time in people's back kitchens.
No. You wouldn't, because you see, with a real car, you've got things to keep you on the road, like curbs and pedestrians. The beauty of the driving is being able to get about more, to travel farther afield. Anyway, you can scoff.
I would if I had something to scoff. Had you got any of them mints?
Hey, dear. There. Just look at it. Like feeding a ready-mixed concrete machine. Just the same at school, him and Doggy Eastwood. He used to eat everything but the inkwells. Do you know what his technique was? He used to spit on somebody's bun and say, you don't want that, do you?
And you go straight from that to Elgar in the music room, struck even at that age by the rich possibilities of life.
It were only when he climbed the SS medical and they discovered he had a Jewish left leg that he signed on with the Catering Corps.
I was not a member of the Catering Corps. It was the Fighting Royal Signals.
And a right lot of poofs they were.
Swift and Shaw was our motto. Sotos Sitar, the technological brains of the British Army.
We had one of them in our mob. He couldn't find his way to cookout.
Well, it's hardly worth his while, was it, if you'd all been spitting on his bun?
I was there when it came to the fight for freedom.
Only him, you know. He's all on his jacket.
Well, I was there willingly at the time. But when you look around and see what they've done with the freedom, a thought occurs that I might just as well have stayed at home and scraped together a deposit for Cynthia Merchingrove.
Oh, no, you were better off on the battlefield, honest.
She would have made an excellent wife.
Oh, it doesn't always follow. It doesn't always pay to rely on them being unattractive. Ideally, there ought to be something else.
Well, with a face like hers, you'd soon be looking for something else.
Were you engaged?
Not exactly.
Oh, God, well, now, in those days, it has to be exactly or nothing round here.
No, we had an understanding. She was to be mine the moment I achieved an executive position with a water board. And I had every prospect. People retire, and now and again, somebody would drown. And, of course, the war came and ruined everything.
Oh, you had a narrow squeak there, sir. It would have been just my luck not to have had a damn great war.
She saw me off to the army, tears all over a platform ticket. 6 weeks later, I was back on a 48 to find her betrothed to this under-manager of the Maypole Dairies. He was using his position to supplement her butter ration.
Oh, you get that kind of frenzied madness in every war. People living only for the moment, cramming every instant full of buckshee butter. You don't know how well off you are. How well off are you, incidentally? Can you manage 15 quid?
What?
Well, yeah, he's got the reflexes of a young man. Did you see him leap there like he'd been stung?
You could raise 15 quid, Cyril. I bet you a little nest of it somewhere. Hey, he's got that insurance bullet.
Who told you that?
Everybody knows.
By hell, this is a great area for financial discretion. They even know the value of your spit.
You can put your hands on 15 quid, Cyril, without disturbing your savings.
Well, what if I can?
Don't you go up on the colour when his money's in danger.
And why not? Well, look at you. I can see how stylish poverty is.
I'm happy.
Ah, bloody slap happy. Look where it's got you.
Don't underestimate him, Cyril. He didn't get like that overnight. It's taken him years of dedicated mismanagement.
Hey, give us a bag and I'll let you waggle me loose tooth.
Hey, look at that.
A car?
At that price, we can manage it between us.
I thought you didn't like cars.
Well, it's true. We don't get on them. My dear wife, God rest the silly bitch. Late in life for a one-owner hillman.
Well, you were lucky if I went for a chuffing pool.
Then you have to wax him every Sunday afternoon. Vac his interior. Lift up his bonnet and pull things into his tubes. It was so treacherous, you see. You didn't need a steering wheel, you needed a whip and a flaming chair. I used to set off forwards and it'd go backwards.
Well, you must have been in wrong gear.
Now, that's what the world was supposed to think, but I knew that that shiny metallic monster was changing its own gears. Oh, no, I've not been all that good at driving, but it used to make me look a right promise fool.
What do you want another one, then, for?
Well, I don't want to look like that. Nothing you've got to polish. But something like this. A trapped-out old banger that'll just take us where we want to go. I've still got this driving license. We've got all this spare time. We can get about and do more.
Ah, we could go to your races.
Mobility's a kind of freedom, long as you're not always polishing it. If we both chipped in 15 quid, we could get more.
What about him?
Like I said, if we both chipped in 15 quid, we can get one.
Oh, I could maintain it for you. I'm very good with my hands.
Everybody knows that. Mrs. Batty's forever complaining.
Fascinating information. We can stop wasting this gentleman's time. Don't rush up. I've got just the car for you. You couldn't have come at a better time. I haven't even advertised it yet. It's the fastest little wagon on four wheels.
How much?
Hey, you bet we're fast and all. Don't worry. It's a snip. A super snip. And here's a pump right down the floor. Did she terrify you?
She's been terrifying me since we managed to push down the damn thing.
Oh, once you get her battery charged, she'll be as look at that footwork, eh? Walnut.
Ask myself whether it's fitting for three old men to be hurtling about in this thing at nearly 30 miles an hour.
Hey, is your car like it don't work?
Oh, Compo Simonite, you're a fine one to be complaining about help not working.
Hey, you bitch, look, the engine is key. Don't distract him. Keep his eyes on road.
From here, there's a magnificent view of that red warning light on the dashboard.
She's a luxury motor that belonged to a title lord. Look at them switches, eh? Crammed full of extras.
No essentials, just extras.
A minute, your mate, isn't he? Oh, right. I'm not saying she doesn't need tidying up here and there.
Hey, can that doggy horse really ride the bike? He'll have to walk it. Can't rely on the damn car.
Bloody thing's got no sense of balance.
Listen, I've been thinking that what we ought to do is to slow down before this next hill.
To be absolutely honest, I think you're going to need a new set of brake linings. Don't touch him with a barge pole.
There's a free CID man with every pack.
Like that, is it?
You'll give me flaming long spreading rumours like that. I'm in enough trouble as it is. I'm supposed to be selling that car commissioned for this fella. He's about 8 foot tall and chunky with it.
Oh, I can't stop here gapping. I'm going underground.
You mean like at your funeral?
No, not like at a funeral. What a lousy thing to say. He's got so much to live for, has Walter.
Aye, all that stuff in front room. Hey, what about... Oh, Ivy. What about some sugar then?
Oh, they know where it is if you change your mind about the spaghetti.
Hey, Ivy. This is Walter.
His dog rides a bicycle, that one.
No, we don't, Mrs. Keeps falling off.
You men, you get dafter. What's this about spaghetti? Now, don't you go touching on any of that knocked-off stuff.
Ivy, leave him. Run away with me. You're looking very edible.
You get on with your tea.
Hey, made you an offer. Least you can do is think about it.
In half an hour, turn that oven down to number 3.
Oh, I can't stand all this romantic chatter. You're driving me wild. Have you been having her done up?
Well, I didn't get a gram for it, if that's what you mean. Is it left and up for reverse or left and down?
Does it matter anymore?
Well, it didn't seem to matter with that Hillman. She went backwards wherever I pointed her.
All right. It's bound to be a bit scratched, but I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll knock a fiver off. Now, that's giving it away.
Yeah, well, we're going after something smaller.
How lucky can you be? Because after a crunch like that, it's got to be smaller.
If you're unlucky with cars, why persist? It isn't as if there's a shortage of hazards on the roads. Nobody's going to miss your contribution.
It's a challenge. A man needs to be stretched to his limits sometimes, as when changing a light bulb, for instance.
I bet these in the winter cost more than 30 quid.
What do you think? You never know round here. The drives you spare. They could be worth a fortune and still dress like somebody's armpit. My advice, you'll only get snotty with those customers that come dressed up. They're the real peasants these days. He's only doing it a bit though, ain't he, with the welly. Less than a minute to drown in. It looked just like that. Get you something to drink about, ain't you?
It
It's a bit rough, this road.
It's a bit rough, this driving.
I'm just getting the hang of it.
Put your dog in. Put your dog in.
I thought it was the indicator.
We're not going backwards, are we?
Oh, a terrific sense of direction, this lad.
Wonderful impression of speed through the holes in these floorboards. I think after we've gone a bit further, we ought perhaps to get out and be sick.
Star. That's here on UK TV Drama.